Okay, hello everyone. Please pay attention. So, we'll continue with our strategic cost management perspective. We have discussed total cost of ownership, right? We have seen, like, you know, what are the mechanisms by which a supply manager can kind of estimate what should be the right price by using price analysis. So, many a times if we cannot estimate price or if we cannot do something with the price, okay, we have seen various mechanisms, for example, quantity discounts, volume discounts, cash discounts, variable pricing. So, or one other method is, like, you know, if we are dealing with raw material and whatever commodities, if we are dealing with commodities, right, and there are many exchanges at international level, global level, at national level, one can compare, you know, the changes in price with the changes what suppliers are quoting over a period of time. So, that can also be a good benchmark to evaluate what are the prices. But many times, like, we are not aware of, we cannot estimate the prices. For example, if it is a new project, new product, okay. So, in that case, one can explore if cost analysis can be done, okay. So, the cost analysis, so we do cost analysis when price analysis is impractical or when we want to purchase non-standard item and services. So, what cost analysis does, this reviews, right, or evaluate the actual or anticipated costs using experience, knowledge and judgment, right? That's where, you know, the supply management knowledge and like, you know, information about all the commodities, parts, basically about the supply market and the products and projects which supply managers are dealing with. So, that information and knowledge is very important so that one can estimate costs, right, and serve as a basis for buyer-seller negotiations also, right? So, if we have good information, if we have good command about supply market, about, you know, various cost components, one can negotiate with the suppliers, right? So, again, the purpose is same as we have mentioned in the beginning of strategic cost management, that how we can arrive at a fair price for both supplier and buyer, right? So, when we say cost analysis, right, we as supply manager, we will be able to estimate the costs only if we have the basic knowledge about categories of cost, right? Direct cost, indirect cost, right? Because if I have to evaluate, two things are there, you know, if we have to evaluate the supplier for whether they are charging right price or not, one should consider that while deciding the price, they have to consider what cost they are incurring in producing or converting the product or developing the service product, plus profit margin. These two things will put together would result in the final price. So, when we will talk about cost, so as supply manager, I should be aware of what are direct costs, what are indirect costs, okay. So, direct costs, like, you know, the costs which are contributed by the parts or, you know, components which goes in the finished goods, right. However, indirect are all other things than what we have said. Okay, the energy, the water, the electricity, right, or the tools, the machinery which we use. So, all those are indirect costs. Okay, so this is very important. One must be aware of this thing. Okay, so and we must be aware of, as supply manager, we should also know that how suppliers are using various cost based models to arrive at the price. Right, they might be using cost markup pricing model, right, where the desired profits are obtained by adding a markup percentage to the estimated cost, right? For example, if they have estimated some cost, let's say figure of 50, so they will have some markup percentage, let's say 20% of whatever cost they incur. So 20% of that plus the total cost would be the price. So this can be one of the model supplier might be using. So another can be margin pricing. So margin pricing is that, you know, this is like while deciding the selling price. So as the word says margin, it is used for the unit of product, right? So how this can be set, maybe whatever cost we would incur, right? So this is not on the cost markup, but it is like if a company would say some margin rate, of selling price, okay? So if my unit selling price is this, so it should be, I should be keeping 10%, 12%, 20% of margin for the price, whatever price I would set. That means to find out unit selling price, I know this is the cost, but my margin is marginal rate multiplied by unit selling price, right? So with this, you know, you do your arithmetic and we will arrive at this figure. That means if I want to keep some margin, if supplier wants to keep margin of 20% on the selling price, then what should be the selling price given the cost, okay? So now you see that the price would, so if the cost remains same as 50, the price would be 62.50, right? So we are with this exercises, we are also trying to analyze, like, you know, why and how suppliers are charging different prices. One must be aware of like, you know, how the prices are charged, right? Third can be rate of return pricing model, right? The supplier might say that whatever is the desired profits, right, they should be based on the financial investment rather than estimated cost, right? For example, if supplier has decided to invest this much amount, 30,000, right, to make 4,000 parts, right, with each part costing 50 in monetary units. So if I want 20% on the return on investment, what should be my price? Okay, so 30,000 is total investment. If I know I'm going to make 4,000 parts or the number of parts, so per unit investment will be 20%. Per unit return I'm expecting on the investment is this component, okay? So you see that now the price is 65, right? So many a times when we have discussed a topic on negotiation, right? So many a times one can also set this thing on negotiation, how they are determining this, you know, so-called what model they use, or if you can make out what model they use, you know, one can evaluate, you know, whether we are paying right price or not, okay? So this is one. Then there can be reverse price analysis, okay? If many a times, you know, the purchasers are expert in the area, they know the cost of each raw material, part, component, everything which goes into it, you just go for reverse pricing, break down the cost and estimate whether they have, the suppliers are charging the right cost or not, okay? And another is collaborative approaches to cost management, which is called target pricing or costing. So this is the, this is called, like, you know, designing costs out of products and services rather than eliminating costs after production, okay? What does this mean? That it is like, you know, it also comes under the category of, like, you know, collaboration, collaborative approaches to cost management, where supplier, buyer, or suppliers and buyer, they collaborate, you know, by collaborate on certain aspects of reducing the cost. Means there can be different models, but one very famous model is the target pricing or costing. So in that, what supplier buyer decides that they would set a target price first, right? For example, in the last class, we were discussing that, you know, in India, we had a Tata Nano, which was like, you know, the Tata chairman announced, you know, that they're going to build a car worth 1 lakh, right? So that price was announced, okay? So after, you know, the target pricing, or you can say target costing, you know, I will come to target costing also. Once the target pricing is set, then, you know, the designing costs out of products, you know, what, then supplier buyer, they collaborate, right, and take the share of, you can say, or take the responsibility of taking the costs out. For example, design to cost means the design team takes share of, like, you know, how they are going to reduce the cost, manufacture to cost, and purchase to cost. So every entity, you know, that's why, you know, at the very stage of design, you know, all these three stakeholders, the design team of buyer, the manufacturing team of buyer, and the suppliers, like, you know, these three, they work backwards just like that here. So if this is the current price, right, so we will be, they will be, like, you know, reaching to the target price, and if the target is this target cost, then, you know, everyone will have, you know, the contribution to reduce the cost, right? So this is, like, you know, how one can, this is just an indicator of, like, you know, how these three sections predominantly can contribute in doing that. So I have uploaded, you know, I'm not sure if I have uploaded on Moodle, or you can search that, you know, how this Tata Nano, you know, they have divided on similar lines, like, you know, what design section would do, how manufacturing can be done, and how suppliers, like, you know, suppliers helped them to come up with a material which was low cost material, right? And many other aspects, like, you know, suppliers have had been able to help, like, you know, Tata Nano in bringing the cost down, right? So you would see that, you know, they were able to integrate one or two systems of a car, right, which were very cost effective. So I will share that small reading on this thing, which will clearly describe about how, you know, each section was contributed toward target pricing, right? So now while doing the cost analysis, one must analyze that should the price be calculated on percentage of cost basis, right? Like we have seen the markup model, right? So because, you know, when you as supply manager would decide, like, you know, which supplier to award the contract, right, or which supplier should be selected, one might think that, you know, should I award a supplier who is determining the price based on the percentage of cost basis, okay? Now then the question will come, you know, if you would say yes, right, the counter question may come that, you know, why a supplier who is incurring more cost, that means who is not that efficient, should be given award, isn't it, right? Now how would you determine which supplier is efficient, which is not, okay? So this is a full analysis, like, you know, should it be based on relationship of capital investment required to produce the profit, right? These are the questions, like, you know, food for thought for all of us, right? Because there are many reasons, like the supplier is not efficient enough, or supplier is not producing good volumes of product, right? Or supplier is lacking in automation, right? Or there can be many other reasons. Supplier is just a new supplier. That's why, you know, the learning curve has not set in, and that's why, you know, they are incurring more cost, and hence charging more price, right? So how to determine fair profit? One must focus on the efficient production, means greater profits, repeat orders, Okay. So one should incentivize, you know, the supplier or vendor who is efficient. It cannot be fixed percentage, rather it should be flexible. So reward for risk taking and efficiency also, right? So this is a high time when one must give impetus on the innovation capability of suppliers. High rupee profit per unit of product purchased on small special orders. So there are, you know, in nutshell, one must look at all the aspects, like, you know, of supplier, what volume they are producing, at what rate they are producing, what is the automation, innovation, how they have been doing for the past so many years, right? So keeping all this cost components in mind, okay? These days, many companies, what they do, they ask the supplier to give the cost breakdown, okay? If, you know, if you cannot judge the cost component, if they are not available, you can, in fact, contact the suppliers. So one may question why suppliers would share, right? These days, at least in auto industry, suppliers are happy to share this thing because there's a good understanding between supplier and buyer, right? So the suppliers, they can actually give the cost breakdown, right? So for example, if it is material, then how they determine the material, the labor, the fabrication, investment, logistics, right? So all this cost breakup, right? It's not necessarily, you know, one should not think that, you know, this exercise would can be used for squeezing suppliers. It's not that, okay? It is more of like, you know, whether I can help supplier, right, in bringing some costs down, okay? I'm not sure, like, you know, in our last session, whether this example was shared in the class or this thing that, you know, most of the auto giants, like, you know, when they buy steel, right? So they don't buy steel only for their own organization, right? Because steel is a commodity which is very volatile in prices, okay? So now imagine, like, you know, auto giant, like, I think 70% to 80% of, you know, the component we can say in any auto vehicle is steel actually, okay? And, you know, when, and other things, when they procure from tier 1, tier 2, tier 3 suppliers, they also need steel, right? And now, you know, first is the what grade of steel each supplier in the supply chain is using, at what price they are buying, right? So what, so the price at which even tier 3, tier 4 supplier is buying, that would affect the final product price, you know, down the line in the supply chain, right? So now many auto giants, what they are doing is they are kind of setting up, you know, a trade office where they would procure the steel for all their suppliers, right? So that improves their negotiation power. They can buy volumes, right? And they can buy the steel of the quality grade which they want to be in their finished product. Okay, that's a very good model, right? So then the suppliers, then they buy from that auto giant, then they convert into their components all, again, sell those components to the same auto giants. So this exercise, like, you know, the cost breakdown exercise, this is a caution, should not be, like, you know, mistook as it is for the squeezing the price exercise, okay? So many innovative ideas can be generated to reduce the cost, right? So this is in nutshell an overview of, like, you know, how cost analysis is done.